Bengal tiger is being driven to extinction in the wild. It's clear that radical conservation measures are needed if they are to survive outside of zoos. Public pressure is growing to change the way international development is shaped by agencies like the World Bank. In response, governments have poured billions of dollars into a little-known aid fund called the Global Environment Facility, or GEF. It funds projects that are meant to be at the cutting edge of conservation, made in partnership with local communities, and that provide an example for the World Bank to follow. To see how such global ideals relate to local realities, we travelled from a tiger conservation project called Eco Development in the forests of southern India to Washington DC, where the GEF works from inside the World Bank headquarters. The journey starts as we show the GES promotional video in one of 58 indigenous settlements inside Negaholi National Park.
Poverty forces millions to overexploit nature, while uncontrolled growth often ignores environmental safeguards. Our air and water are poisoned. Animals and plants face extinction. We must therefore take up the challenge, fight climate change, save the ozone layer, protect our plants and animals. The Global Environment Facility, caring for the planet.
ಸ್ವಾತಂತ್ರ್ಯ ಕಾರ್ಡ್ನ ಶಿಬಿರ ಬಂದಿದ್ದಲ್ಲ ತಿಂದು ಆರಂಭದಲ್ಲಿ ರಾಜರಾಗಿ ಅದೇ ಬದುಕಬೇಕು ಅದು ಅವ್ರ ಜೀವಮಾನ ಸರಿಯಾದ ರೀತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಬೆಳವಣಿಗೆ ಇದು ಅವರು ನಾಟಕ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದ ಥರ ಸರ್ಕಾರದ ಉದ್ದೇಶ ಬಂತು ಹತ್ತನೇ ವರ್ಷದಿಂದ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು ನೀವು ಕಾಡಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಇರೋಂಗಿಲ್ಲ ಸೈಡ್ ಬನ್ನಿ ನಾವು ಕೂಪ್ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಡ್ತೀವಿ ನಿಮಗೆ ಜಾಗ ಕೊಡ್ತೀವಿ
ಆಗ ಅಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಏನಾಯ್ತು ಓ ನೀವು ದಾಟಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ನಮ್ಮ ಕಾಡು ಹತ್ತಿದ್ರೆ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಕಡ್ಕತ್ತಿ ಕೇಳ್ತೀವಿ ನಿಮ್ಮನ್ನ ಗುಂಡಾಕಿ ಸುಡ್ತೀವಿ ಅಂತ ಬಂತು
ನೇಮಂಟಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಯಾವುದೇ ತರಲಿಲ್ಲ
There is a competition here in India between human being and tiger. Human population has doubled in last 25 years. Therefore, something has to be given to the villagers for their own sustenance, which reduces their pressure on the forest. That was the concept of eco-development.
The basic idea of the project is to keep animals inside the park and people outside.
Some of the people in the village, they'll be depending, selling the forest produce to the far off places and making their livelihood. If at all we provide them an alternative livelihood, they're using these funds.
India Eco Development Project, 1997-98.
It is they alone have to tell us what is good for them and how they can benefit and what is the role of the people to be played in the protection of the national park.
He is the president, not chairman, president of the India Eco Development Project of this village. So these people will sit together and decide who should get what. So this is the plan of this village. Got it. So this plan was approved from Washington. So we'll go to the shopkeeper now. We have financed him 8,100 rupees to purchase these commodities. So by that his economic standard is increased now. We have a lot of influence on the minds of the people. Now we can ask them to say, don't go inside the park.
Out of earshot of the officials, some landless women of the village took a different view of eco development.
Machine. ಅದಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರ ನಾವ್ ಕೇಳ್ತಾ ಇರೋದು ನಮ್ಮ ಕಾಡಕ್ ಬಿಡಕ್ಕೆಲ್ವಾ ಇದಿಷ್ಟು ಸೌಲಭ್ಯ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಿ, ಒಂದ್ ವರ್ಷ ಎರಡ್ ವರ್ಷ ಮೂರ್ ವರ್ಷ ಮಾರನೆ ನೀರತ್ಗೆ ಐದ್ ವರ್ಷ ಕಾಲ ಕಳೆಯನ ಇವ್ರು ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ರಲ್ಲಿ ಆಚೆಗೆ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೇವೆ ನಾವಿರ ಗಂಟ ಮಾಡ್ತೇವೆ. ಈ ಮಕ್ಳನ್ನ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡೋದ ನಾವು?
That is other side of the road is the park.
Other side of the road is the park. This side is the village.
Yeah, I'll show you while going.
So we are proposing to improve the tourism facilities for the people, and we want the tribal people should be involved in tourism aspect also. People inside the park, basically they are deprived of most of the basic communities. As and when immediately when they come out to the periphery of the park, they will be eligible for getting this all the benefits from the eco-development project.
ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ತೀವಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ಅಷ್ಟೇ, ಅದೇ ತುಂಬ ಜನರಿಗೆ ಯಾವ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡಿ ನನ್ನ ಹೆಸರು ಕೆಲಸ ಅಂತೇಳಿ ನಾನು ಈ ನಾಗರೋಳೆ ಕಾಗನಕೋಟೆ ಹಕ್ಕು ಸ್ಥಾಪನೆ ಸಮಿತಿಯ ಸಹ ಸಂಚಾಲಕನಾಗಿ ಒಂದು ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ. ನಾವು ಇಲ್ಲೇ ಸ್ವತಂತ್ರ ಬೆಳೆದಂಥವ್ರು, ಈ ಕಾಗನಿಗಳು ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ಈ ಜೀವನದಲ್ಲಿ ಬೆಳೆಸು ಅದೇ ರೀತಿ ನಾವು ಬೆಳೆದವರು. ನಾವು ಹೊರಗಡೆಯಿಂದ ಯಾವ ಸಿಟನ್ನ ಬಂದ್ಕೊಂಡವ್ರು ನಾವು ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಈ ಊಟ ಅನ್ನೋದು ಸದ್ಯ ಅಕ್ಕಿ ಕಡಿಮೆ ರೇಸಿಂಗ್ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಬರೀ ಗೆಡ್ಡೆ ಗೆಣಸು ಸೊಪ್ಪು ಆಹಾರಗಳಿದ್ದು ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಉಪಯೋಗಿಸಿದ್ರು
ಸೊಳ್ಳೆಣ್ಣು ಅಂತ ತಿನ್ಬೋದು.
ಈ ರೀತಿ ಮೂರು ತಿಂಗಳು ಅದು ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಜೈನ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಮೂರು ತಿಂಗಳು ನಡೀತಿದೆ. ಅದರಿಂದ ನಾವು ಅದನ್ನ ಜೈನ ಗುರುಗಳು
ಏನು ಮಾಡಂಗಿಲ್ಲ, ನಮ್ಮ ದೇವ್ರ ಸಂಘದ ಮಿಕ್ಕಿಗಳು ನಾವು ಅದ್ರ ನಾವು ದೇವ್ರ ಸಂಬಂಧ ಬದುಕಿದಂಗೆ ನಮಗೆ ಕಂಡ್ರೆ ಅವ್ರು ಎದುರ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರೆ ನಾವು ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಕಂಡ್ರೆ ನಾವು ಎದುರ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ.
ನನ್ನ ಹೆಸರು ಸೋನಿಯಮ್ಮ. ನಮಗೆ ಅದನ್ನ ಬಿಟ್ಟು ನಾವು ಆಡುಗಳಿಗೆ ಬೋರ್ವೆಲ್ ಕಂಪ್ನಿ ಮಾಡಿದೀವಿ. ನನ್ನ ಹುಡುಗ, ನನ್ನ ಸೊಸೆ ಮತ್ತು ನಮ್ಮ ಮನೆಯವರು ನಾವು ಮತ್ತು ಆ ಮನೇಲಿ ನನ್ನ ಮಗಳು ಅಳಿಯ ಅವರೆಲ್ಲ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಹೊಟ್ಟೆಗೆ ತುಂಬ ಕಷ್ಟ ಕೆಲಸ. ಅದು ನೀವು ಕಳ್ತನ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಿ ಕಾಡೋರಿಗೆ ಹೋಗ್ಬಾರ್ದು ಅಂತ. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ನಾವು ಹೋಗ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಬಂದು ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಕಳ್ತನ ಆಗಿರೋ ತೀರಾ ನಾವು ಕಂಡ್ಕೋತೀವಲ್ಲ ಕಾಡೊಳಗೆ ಏನೆಲ್ಲ ಆಗತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ನಾವು ಗಿರಿಜನರು ಕಂಡುಬಿಟ್ರೆ ನಾವು ಆದಿವಾಸಿಗಳು ಹಾಗೆ ಕಳ್ತನ ಮಾಡೋದಾಗಿದೆ. ಆಗಳಿಗಿಂತ ನಮ್ಮ ತಾತನ ತಂದೆ ತಾಯಿಗಳಿಗೆ ನಾವು ಹುಟ್ಟಿ ಬೆಳೆದಂತ ಮನುಷ್ಯರು ಆಗ ಕಳ್ತನ ಮಾಡೋದಾಗಿದ್ರೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಕಾಡು ಹೆಂಗೆ ಬೆಳೆಸ್ಕೊಂಡು ಬಂದು
ನಾವು ಬದುಕಿದ್ದು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಅಲ್ಲ, ನಾವು ಕಾಡು ಮಧ್ಯ ಒಂದು 30-35 ಕಿಲೋಮೀಟ್ರ್ ಒಳಗಡೆ ನಾವು ಬದುಕಿದಂಥವ್ರು. ಕೆಲವು 30 ಕಿಲೋಮೀಟ್ರ್ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ, ಈಗಲೂ ಇದೆ ಜನ ಕಾಡಿನ ಒಳಗಡೆ. ಕೈಮಾರ ಅಂತ ಇದೆ, ಅವರು ಫಾರೆಸ್ಟ್ನವರು ಕೆಲಸಕ್ಕೆ ಕೂಲಿ ಕೆಲಸಕ್ಕೆ ಬಳಸ್ಕೊಂಡು ಅಲ್ಲೇ ಬಿಟ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ.
ಇವಾಗ ಅದು ಕೆಲವು ನಾಗರಿಕತೆ ಬಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ಟಿದೆಯಲ್ಲ ಕಾಡಿನಿಂದ ಹೊರಗಡೆ ಬಂದರೆ ಅದು ಎಷ್ಟೋ ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಹೋಗಿದೆ. ಅದು ನಾವು ಎಷ್ಟೋ ಮರ್ತೋಗ್ಬಿಟ್ಟಿದ್ದೋ, ಅದು ನಡೆಸ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಈ ಕೋಲಾಟ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ ಅದು ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಹೋಗಿತ್ತು.
ಒಳಗಡೆ ಇರೋ ತುಂಬ ತಪ್ಪು ಅನ್ನೋದು ನಮ್ಮ ಜನರಿಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿತ್ತು, ಗೊತ್ತೇ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ರು. ಆಮೇಲೆ ನಾವು ಕಾಡು ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಹೊರಗಡೆ ಬಂದ ಮೇಲೆ ಈ ಪರಿಸ್ಥಿತಿಲಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ಕಡೆಗೆ ನಾವು ಕೂಲಿ ಮಾಡಿ ಜೀವದ ಅಕ್ಕಿ ರೇಸಿನ ಇಂಥದ್ದನ್ನ ಉಪಯೋಗಿಸಲು ಶುರು
ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀವಿ. ನಿಮಗೆ ಲಾಭ ಇರೋದಕ್ಕೆ ತಾನೇ ನೀವು 20-30 ವರ್ಷ ಒಂದೇ ಜಾಗದಲ್ಲಿ ಇರೋದು. ನಮಗೆ ಬಡಸ್ತಾನೆ ಆಗಿದ್ರೆ ನೀವು ಇಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಖಾಲಿ ಆಗತ್ತಿದ್ರಿ. ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಖಾಲಿ ಆಗಂಗಿಲ್ಲಲ್ಲ, ನಿಮಗೆ ಬಂದ್ಕೊಂಡೆ ಲಾಭ ಇಟ್ಕೊಂಡೇ ಇದೆಯಲ್ಲ, ಅದಕ್ಕೆಲ್ವ ನೀವು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಇರೋದು 3 ವರ್ಷ ಗಂಟ ಒಂದೇ ಜಾಗದಲ್ಲಿ. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ನಮ್ಮಂತ ಬಡವ್ರನ್ನ ನೀವು ಓಡಿಸ್ತಾ ಇರೋದು.
They are addicted towards this alcohol, most of them are addicted to alcohol, cheap rate of alcohol, that this thing, spirit. they don't save anything. Basically, this is the main thing. Tribals don't have a habit of saving anything. Government is very much concerned in the improvement of the tribals. So here we have another project, rehabilitation project also. Culture, tradition and all can be maintained.
We are in a rehabilitation site exactly now. We are constructing 50 tribal houses. Yeah, this is living room come hall. As we come over here, and this is the room, bedroom sort of thing. Yeah, bedroom and store and all, everything, this covers that. And this is the bathroom. Still the doors have to be fixed now.
These people should also be enjoy the benefits and also enter the mainstream of the society, should become decision makers, should become policy makers. They have been exposed to the society at last. So they are not Adivasis. You cannot call them Adivasis. What do you mean by Adivasi? Adivasi, you can call some tribes in Andaman as Adivasi, who has not seen the light of the development. Got it?
ಅಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಪುರ ನಾವು ಒಗ್ಗಟ್ಟಾಗಿ ನಿಂತ್ಕೊಂಡು ನಾವು ಯಾವ್ದೇ ಇದ್ರು ನಾವು ಇದು ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಹೋಗಲ್ಲ.
ಅವರು ಮೋಟರ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ನಮ್ಗೆ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರು ಕೋಳಿ ನಾಯಿ ಸಾಕಾಣ ಮೇಲೆ ಕಾಡಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಬರ್ತಾ ಅವರು ದೊಡ್ಡ ದೊಡ್ಡ ಮೋಟರ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ
ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡು
ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಅದ್ರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ವಿಚಾರಿಸ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು
ಆನೆ ಬಂದರು ಒಂದದಿಲೆ.
Kenchara was one of three Adivasi from Nagaholi Forest who made the two-day train journey to Delhi for the Global Environment Facility's first participants' assembly.
ವಾಹನಗಳು ಹೊಗೆ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಮೂಗಿ ತಟ್ಟಗಳು ಕೊಳೆ ಬರಕಾಗ.
Before the big meetings began, there was a day of consultations where activists could challenge the World Bank and the GEF directly over their backing for projects like eco development.
ಮೀಟಿಂಗ್ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಹೇಳಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ನಾವು ಹೋದ ಉದ್ದೇಶ ಒಳ್ಳೆಯ ಉದ್ದೇಶ ಆಯ್ತು. ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್ನ
With $2.7 billion of new money pledged and 128 governments represented, the assembly was the GEF's chance to establish its place on the international stage.
They all talk in jargon, which is very familiar to each other and totally incomprehensible to outside. But maybe that's the agenda.
Since the NGOs are such an important part of the body of the GEF, then we all listen.
Listening to the local communities, that's a procedure by itself that the GEF follows. Now, here we have people from a project site who are saying that we have not been consulted, this is not our project, this project is going against our basic livelihood.
This is not going to be an easy issue to deal with. However thoroughly we prepare it, however much we consult in the process, this was one of the most expensive and participatory projects in terms of preparation that the bank or the GEF have ever been involved in.
Sunita Narayan.
You talk about participation without giving people control. The problem with the project is World Bank and the Forest Department. They are two partners who are both extremely arrogant and two partners who treat forests as their fiefdoms.
That really is a gross misstatement of the efforts that we have made to listen and to respond. The villagers are not required to do anything under this project. They are given the opportunity if they wish to take it.
The government believes, and to a large extent, I would imagine the World Bank believes, that they are doing something radically different. I don't believe so. The approach was to say that people were the biotic interference. They were not needed in the protected area, and therefore they needed to be removed.
Let me just remind you that the preparation of this project was actually conducted by an Indian NGO professional institute
I was the person who the government of India asked to design the India Eco-Development Project, my institute and I, and we did it. You can't sit in Delhi in air-conditioned comfort and say, no, but you must live in the jungle the way people have lived in the jungles. And if they want to change, all you have to do is make sure that that transitional process is as ecologically friendly as possible. There was an ideological criticism of people who were opposed to institutions like the World Bank and GEF. And I said to them that, look, I can get the World Bank to use some of their money progressively. If this money was not used for eco-development, it's a country-committed fund, it would go to build a dam.
This is what the people are saying, that in our community, the project is simply just not working, and therefore something needs to be done. And it is my hope that something will be done. Thank you.
It is frankly ridiculous to say that this project is not working, and we can't possibly know at this stage whether it's working or not.
You're creating a new process of alienation, and you've only made the words more sophisticated. The actions don't meet the words. Thank you.
It was very clear that the agenda is very limited. It is to celebrate 5 years of GEF rather than change its framework, think about where it's really going wrong, and make bold decisions. It was too much money wasted on an event that that was not so impactful.
ಅವರೇ ಕುಂತ ಅವರೇ ಏಜಿನ ಹಾಕಿ ಈ ತರದಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಏಜಿನ ಹಾಕಿದೀವಿ ಈ ತರ ಕಾನೂನು ಬದ್ರೆ ಮಾಡಿದೀವಿ ಈಗ ಕಾರ್ಡ್ ಬಿಟ್ಕೊಡಿ ಅಂದಾಗ ಇದು ಲಗತ್ತಲ್ಲ
people in the local areas are the ones who are most concerned about the local environment. It's the bigger fishes who have moved from one places to another with no roots anywhere are the ones that are creating the problem.
Increasingly, it is a centralized or a faraway bureaucracy which makes decisions which affect the lives of local communities. They have the maximum stake in their environment, but they have the least amount of ability to make those decisions.
There is a total living in a different world.
Across the world in Washington, D.C., it's business as usual at the World Bank headquarters, where the Global Environment Facilities Secretariat is based. It was time to explore how hundreds of projects are funded from Washington in the name of the global environment. We went to D.C. with a video letter from the people of Mega Holy Forest, addressed to the staff of the GEF and the World Bank. Despite promising to be completely open about their work, GEF Secretariat staff were advised not to appear in this film. Others, however, were less reticent.
I'm Robin Broadfield. I got embroiled in that debate, trying to defend the bank, get the facts on the table of the extensive consultation that we and the Indian authorities had in fact undertaken in the Nangarhole area, but recognizing perhaps that we hadn't done as comprehensive a job of consultation with the communities as perhaps we could have done. I've had a quite a long career in the World Bank. I've been a bank staff person for over 14 years now. I'm a sort of middle person here between the client and the GEF institutions. I do get to enjoy the very pleasant experience of living and working in Washington here at the World Bank headquarters.
Right, that'll work fine. All right then.
You change the development path that countries follow by offering the incentive of GEF financing on top of a World Bank loan to redesign a project in a way that is more globally environment friendly.
The challenge is, how can governments get to grips with reducing our impact on the global environment, but while continuing economic development? The GEF is actually a very important instrument. It's got a modest amount of money. The current replenishment was $2.5 billion over a 4-year period. to address issues of climate change and biodiversity that are very, very large in magnitude.
So I see the GEF as really the facilitator in a locally managed process of consultation, negotiation, hopefully reaching agreement and then implementing a collaborative way of managing these natural resources.
ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಹೇಳ್ಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ನಾವು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಬದುಕ ಈ ಕಾರ್ಡ್ನ ನಂಬಿ ಬದುಕಂತ ಜನ
ಮತ್ತೆ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಸುಳ್ಳು ಹೇಳ್ದಾಗ ಈ ಸತಿ ನಮ್ಗೆ ನಮ್ಮ ತಲೆಗೆ ಕಲ್ಲಾಕದಾಗೆ ಅವ್ರು ಕಲ್ಲಾಕಕ್ಕೆ ಬಂದಿರೋದಾದ್ರೆ ಹಣನು ಬರೋದು ಬೇಡ ಅಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಹಣ ತಲುಪಿಸಿ ಹಣ ಇಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ಬರೋದು ಬೇಡ ನಾವು ಇಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಖಾಲಿ ಮಾಡೋದು ಇಲ್ಲ
ನಮಗೆ ಒತ್ತಾಯ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ನಾವು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಅವಕಾಶ ಕೊಡಲ್ಲ ನೀವು ಕಾರ್ಡ್ ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಹೊರಗಡೆ ಬನ್ನಿ ಅಂದಾಗ ಯಾವುದೇ ಹಣದ ಆಗಿರ್ಬೋದು ಮನೇನ ಸಾಕಣ ಆಗಿರ್ಬೋದು ನಾವು ಯಾವುದೇ ತಗೊಂಡಿದ್ದೀವಿ
ಮತ್ತೆ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅತಿ ಹೊರಗಡೆ ಹೋದ್ರೆ ನಾವು ದಾಟಲ್ಲ ನಮ್ನ ಎಂತ ಕೊಲೆ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ನಾವು ಈ ಜಾಗ ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಮತ್ತೆ ಬಳ್ಳ ನಾಶ ದಾಟೋದೇ ಇಲ್ಲ ನಾವು
ಈಗ ಅದನ್ನ ನಾವು ಅಂತಂತ ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ತರ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡ್ ಈಗ ಅದನ್ನ ಅವ್ರು ಯಾವ ತರ ಇದು ಯಾವ ತರದ ಮೂವ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ನಮಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ ಅದ್ ನೋಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ನಾವು ಮತ್ತೆ ನಮ್ದು ಹೋರಾಟಗಳನ್ನ ಇದು ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಇದು ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ
ಪಾರಿಸ್ನವರು ನಾವೆಲ್ಲ ಒಂದೇ ಆಗಿ ಇದ್ರೆ ಕಾಡನ್ನು ಉಳಿಸ್ಕೋಬಹುದು ಕಾಡನ್ನು ಬೆಳೆಸ್ಕೋಬಹುದು ಅದೇ ಬೇಕು ನಮ್ಗೆ ಆ ದೂಟಿ ಬೇಕು ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಹೇಗೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ
Well, I think there's a genuine, very heartfelt need on the part of the people featured in the video here to work with their local authorities, their forest department, in collaborative ways to better manage the forest resources, and that's exactly the philosophy that the GEF is encouraging.
So why can't scientists and bureaucrats working for the GEF bridge the gap between this philosophy and the reality of situations like that in southern India?
The GEF at the moment seems to be driven more by the donor community. It is young and there's not enough time to penetrate its structures right up to the bottom. Take the World Bank, for instance. It's basically more tuned to address issues with big corporations.
As soon as this idea of some kind of a global fund came up, the World Bank readily offered itself, having been so heavily criticized for its very poor environmental and social record in the past. The bank saw this as an opportunity to actually obtain somewhat of a green veneer by being the main player in the GEF, and it is the main player because it is the administrator of the GEF Trust Fund. It is the main implementing agency, and it houses the GEF Secretariat. It has to move money. It has to make projects and approve them quickly so that at the next round of replenishment negotiations, the GEF can ask for more money. Because should it ask for less, that wouldn't make it look good. The gap between international policymakers on the one hand and local people who are directly affected by the GEF is enormously great.
As we saw in Delhi, some activists and NGOs do try to bridge that gap, not always successfully. So whose voice is heard at the global level? In the GEF's Democratic Governing Council.
It's quite unique, you know, it's quite unique in compared to the other organizations I'm used to. During the time I've been here, I don't think there has been an occasion once where we have to have a vote. So it's more business-like and we want to move ahead and it's more technical.
It is very attractive to individuals in search of a global role, which may not actually change the world very much, but while you're acting there, you know, you feel you're somebody and you're running the world. In practice, there's a lot of politics going on, but it's not admitted.
The GEF aspires to be non-political, preferring to emphasize its scientific and technical expertise.
We've got a very wide range of technical skills we can draw on, and if we have can present a sound rationale for the agreed incremental cost we've estimated, the Secretariat and the Council are usually willing to endorse that.
These civil servants not only become politicians, they also have to defend these institutions and their freedom of criticism and suggesting alternatives is pretty limited.
The message I would send back is that the World Bank has heard your concerns. We fully understand them. We will respect them in the way that we work with the Indian authorities in implementing the eco-development project. We simply have to sit down with the various interest groups in our client countries and try and find a way forward.
I do believe what we're seeing in the World Bank is an evolution where the clients themselves are starting to want cleaner projects.
A lot of international bodies are looking for new tasks, and the environment being an important global one is attracting all international organizations. They all want to have part of the environmental cake, if you like. As globalization continues and there's more responsibility handed in some areas, so international bureaucracies don't have to have a closer look at them. How many countries can have the power to exclude these global interests? Well, not too many countries left, I think.
The World Bank's independent inspection panel investigates disputed projects. It is the last legal recourse for affected communities.
We received a request from a group of tribal people in Lagarahole who claimed that the bank had violated a number of its policies. We went out to the field and we did our own assessment. We broadly found a merit in the complaints. Lack of consultation, prior consultation with the tribals, failure to develop an indigenous people's plan, which is required by bank policy, the absence of choice as to whether the tribals can remain in the park or not.
Despite the standing report, the bank's governing board has decided not to act. In fact, most inspection panel reports are rejected, and bank policy on indigenous peoples is being watered down to avoid it being broken so often.
There are lots of people inside the World Bank who are keen to change the way things work. Some feel helpless. I think some are feeling helpless because a large part of World Bank is dominated by economists who don't want to change the way things work.
As long as you do not change these institutional cultures, even if you have, a number of, sympathetic social scientists on board, they will in the end not do much good.
ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಗಿರಿಜನರು ಕಮಿಟಿಗಾಗಿ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಪಡಿನ ಐಕಾಸಿಗಾಗಿ ತಿಳಿಸಿಬಿಟ್ಟು ನಾವು ಕೊಡ್ತೀವಿ. ನಿಮ್ಮ ಯಜಮಾನರು, ನಿಮ್ಮ ದೇವ್ರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ, ನಿಮ್ಮ ಅಧ್ಯಕ್ಷರಾಗಿರೋರು ಮುಂದಾಳಕ್ಕೆ ಬಂದರೆ ನಾವು ಏನು ತೀರ್ಮಾನ ತೆಗಿಬೇಕು, ನಾವು ಹೇಗೆ ಹಣ ಕೊಡಬೇಕು ಅನ್ನೋದು ತೀರ್ಮಾನ ಅವ್ರು ಕೊಟ್ಟರೆ ಹಣನ ನಾವು ಉಪಯೋಗಿಸೋಕ್ಕೆ ನಮಗೆ ತಯಾರಿದೆ.
I think that's the way GF should be moving towards. Less bureaucracy, less paperwork, less institutional arrangements, more direct responsibility and resources to the people.
Decentralizing control to local communities would make global conservation fairer. But such democracy would challenge the very power structures underlying the global environment facility.
To disguise political decisions as non-political, it's not only dishonest, but it also will alienate many people and in the end will reduce the credibility of these international organizations.
ಹುಲಿ ಬಂದರು ಅಂಜದಿಲೆ, ಆನೆ ಬಂದರು ಅಂಜದಿಲೆ, ನಂದು ಬೆಳೆದ ಮಕ್ಕ ನಂಗ ಯಾರು ಬಂದರು ಅಂಜದಿಲೆ,
ಯಾರು ಬಂದರು ಅಂಜದಿಲೆ ಯಾರು ಬಂದರು ಒಡದಿಲೆ ವೀರ ಸೂರ ನಾಡು ಲುತ್ತಿ ವೀರ ಧೀರ ರಂಗೆ ಬೆಳೆದು ವೀರ ಸೂರ ನಾಡು ಲುತ್ತಿ ವೀರ ಧೀರ ರಂಗೆ ಬೆಳೆ ವೀರರಂತೆ ಮೆರಿತಿಗೆ ಧೀರರಂತೆ ಬೆಳಿತಿಗೆ ವೀರರಂತೆ ಮೆರಿತಿಗೆ ಧೀರರಂತೆ ಬೆಳಿತಿಗೆ ಕಡಲು ಹುಟ್ಟಿ ಕಡಲು ಬೆಳೆದ ಕಾಡು ಕುರುಬ ಮಕ್ಕನಂಗ ಹುಲಿ ಬಂದರು ಅಂಜದಿಲೆ ಆನೆ ಬಂದರು ಅಂಜದಿಲೆ ಹುಲಿ ಬಂದರು ಅಂಜದಿಲೆ ಆನೆ ಬಂದರು ಅಂಜದಿಲೆ ಕಾಡಮ್ಮನ ಮಳ್ಳಲು ಹುಟ್ಟಿ ಕಡಲು ಜೇನು ತಂದು ಯಾರು ಬಂದರು ಅಂಜದಿಲೆ ಯಾರು ಬಂದರು ಒಡಗಿಲೆ ಯಾರು ಬಂದರು ಅಂಜದಿಲೆ ಯಾರು ಬಂದರು ಒಡಗಿಲೆ